Coming from a family with a history of farming in the rural Dakotas, I learned early on the importance of farming to our country. But it goes beyond putting food on the table. Here at Purdue, we are investigating new ways to make transportation fuel from plant material. Called biomass, this material is composed of the leaves, stems, bark, and even crop residues. As a doctoral student here at Purdue, I'm working with researchers from many other fields on ways to make better biofuels. These new technologies could help us end our dependence on dwindling fossil fuel supplies.
The amount of biomass which we can reasonably harvest in a reasonable fashion is not enough, okay? It can only supply 1/4 to 1/3 of the U.S. transportation need. So the question is, how do we get more liquid fuel from biomass? Okay? Either increase the quantity of biomass or increase the yield from a given quantity of biomass.
Here at Purdue, we are exploring a technique called hydropyrolysis that would allow us to use the whole plant to make fuel. In order to understand hydropyrolysis, we first need to understand the structure of plants. Trees and grasses are called lignocellulosic biomass because the cell walls are composed of two important molecules, lignin and cellulose. Pyrolysis involves quickly heating these long cellulose and lignin chains, breaking them apart to generate smaller compounds that can be converted into gasoline and diesel fuel.
What we're trying to do is to use new methods and a fast hydropyrolysis reaction that heats the biomass extremely quickly at a rate of 20,000 degrees per second, and to analyze those very first products to kind of try to capture them to see if they are useful molecules and if we could stop the reaction at that point and prevent it from going to something unusable.
We have used rocket propulsion technology to design a new hydropyrolysis reactor that can heat biomass in hundreds of a second, shattering the biomass apart into smaller molecules. Then we use a very sensitive mass spectrometer to analyze the molecules and find better ways to convert them into gasoline and other fuels.
Most other scientists developing biofuels convert the biomaterial completely into very small molecules that are really easy to characterize. But C3 Bio wants to preserve as many valuable bonds as possible. So our mixtures are gonna be much more complicated and much more difficult to understand.
I believe it's a real technical breakthrough that we're able to analyze and understand these primary products of the pyrolysis reaction. And it gives us the opportunity to think that we might eventually be able to scale this up into a new industry.
With all that's taking place here at Purdue, it's a very exciting time to be working on energy issues that are so important to my generation. By converting the stored energy of biomass to fuels, it's possible to envision a future that transitions from petroleum to plants to energize our world.